string information is you are given a lots of information, but how you put into a table or a circle or what figure you are supposed to use, that is what structuring information is. Okay. Now, good thing is, okay, if you are done with this, your 50% of work is over. When solving any DILR set, okay, structuring is 50% of the solution. Okay. Reasoning skill is applying logic. Okay. So when you have made the structure, but still you have made everything, means you put in all the information, but still there are 20% of the pieces which are not fitting into it. Okay. So for that, what you need is reasoning skills to apply the logic and get those values. Okay. So this is logic. Okay. And last one is calculation. Okay. So this is Kerkal skill, which still you need to ace. Okay. Because if you ace these, this calculation, okay, your reasoning skills improve. If you have good calculation. Okay. So, and believe me, okay, although calculation calculator is given in CAT exam, but that is of no use. You need to have very good speed when you're solving. Okay. So, and always remember, your mind is faster than your hand. Okay, so if you are calculating using pen, okay, or let's say mouse, you will be always slower compared to your mind. So it's better to have those skills. Okay, so these are the three types of skills which are important. Okay, so this is something which you need to practice. Need to practice regularly. So to ace, mean to become very good at calculation skills, what you need to do is you need to start applying your brain rather than pen. And I'll say, jitna alsi banoge, jitna lazy banoge, you'll be better. Okay. Means lazy means not, means wanting to use pen to solve questions. Okay. To solve question and to calculate. Okay. So that is what, these are the three levels. Okay. Now, these are the three skill, four, skills which are required. Okay. Now, comprehension is something which improves, as I told you, with practice. Okay. So, in the beginning, students start with comprehension level of, let's say, I'll say maybe 40 to 80%. Okay. If you keep on working, okay, you can attain 95% to 100% comprehension level, which is almost understanding everything. Okay. Then structuring information. Now thing is, if you are a student who is not into problem solving, let's say if you are not solving, means you are not into solving puzzles and those kind of things, okay, then you will be a bit slow. Okay. So structuring information, okay, so this might be something which is 0 to 60%, depending on your exposure to solve question. Okay, so again, this is, so some of you might have 0% level of solving structuring. Okay, motion, this is why it's important to understand what is the level at which you are coming, you know. So if you are at zero level percent, means structuring levels, structuring skill level, then you need to understand that there's a lot of scope to solve. Okay. Scope to improve. Reasoning, again, this what you need to do is, again, okay, I'll suggest you to solve puzzles. Okay, now I recommend two types of questions, everyone. Okay, two types of puzzles. One is you can solve Kakuro. Okay, if you have not heard about it, I'll say please install an app. Okay, solve some Kakuro puzzles. The logic used to solve Kakuro puzzles is used a lot. Okay. Once you're done with solving 50 to 60 types of 60, you will have fair skill level. Okay. Then one book I recommend is The Greatest Book. Of puzzles and teasers. Okay. So this is something which I feel these two are great resources to build a kind of reasoning skills required for CAT. So that is important. Okay, calculation, which we'll cover in next part. Okay, next. Okay, somebody is asking some questions. Okay, how many sets we have to get 90 percentile. 90 percentile के लिए यू सॉल्व 3 सेट्स करेक्टली आउट ऑफ 8. मीन प्रीवियसली यू गेट अराउंड 36 मार्क्स, यू विल गेट 95 percentile. ओके, सो 3 आउट ऑफ 8 इज फाइन. नाउ कमिंग टू स्ट्रक्चरिंग इंफॉर्मेशन. ओके, सो आई विल जस्ट गिव यू अ केस. ओके, सो I just want you guys to read this till here. Okay. And just tell me what will you make to solve this question. What structure will you make? Is it a table? Is it a, let's say, matrix? What kind of table? Okay. And what are the important parameters which you will consider? Okay. I'll just want you to read this part, the red part which I mentioned. Okay. And okay, so within a minute you are supposed to decide. Please respond on chat what structure will you make to solve and what will be columns and rows. Obviously these are also important. Okay, Mohit, good. Columns, rows, what will be the rows? If you are making matrix, you have to have rows and columns. Good, okay. So that is something which we pretty clear. Okay. So this is the, okay. So if you do that, you'll make a very good structure to solve. Okay. Next, so that's the first part of structuring, which is to make a structure. Okay. This is not the whole thing. Okay. Okay. Now, wait a second. Just a minute, I'll share another document with you guys. Okay, so this is something which I shared with you earlier as well. Next is, okay, let's say again, read it for 2 minutes, everyone, and tell me what you are supposed to make. Means what structure, table or matrix or what form? Yes, yes, I'll share the document as well. Okay. I'm sharing the link here as well, everyone, in the chat. No, Shivani, not correct. Table, okay, Mohit, good. What are the means, columns and rows, or is it sufficient? What are the things we are supposed to make? So table is fine. Sejal, please mute your audio. Okay, so okay, so if you see, okay, I'll just read the part again. We are given information about number of three states, okay, that is given. Okay, 150 villages, 250 villages, 200 villages found at 30,000 kids. Now if you see here, we have information about 80,000 kids. That means there's some other part as well. Okay, now if you read the information here, give the in number of kids in the different types of schools for mothers who dropped out of school before completing primary education. So we have information about mothers who dropped out of the school. So what remaining 12,000 is about mothers who did not drop out of the school. So we have to make another table which will have the remaining information with the same structure. Okay, so same structure for not dropout. Okay. So again, so thing is, you need to understand these small things. Okay, what structure you make, okay, that will help you in solving everything very easily. Okay, then your whole thought process is clear. Okay, so it's like when you're solving means making a code. Okay, you have algorithm is there, then you need to apply logic and everything. That's fine, but the whole process is clear. Okay, where you're fitting into the things. Okay, so okay. Now these two questions I have not given means I just wanted you guys to make the information. Okay. Alternatively, what I'll we can do is, okay, this particular question, since it's visible to everyone, okay, just a minute. Yeah, so here I'll just tell you what exactly we are supposed to mean. Another way to do this is, I'll make a table with everything same. Okay, GPO total, then any WS and total. Now if we want to minimize the because most of the cases, what will happen is when you are solving in the exam, since exam is online, you have to make your own table itself. So you need this existing table also. So you have to, if you make two tables, the way you visualize the information will be difficult. Okay. So instead of making another table with similar information, I'll say is the best mode could be this. Where we are dividing the same information into two parts. Okay, so I'm writing the first part, and the second part will write the information about moms who did not drop out. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we have 9 variables here, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 equations. Okay, so we have 9 variables, 6 equations. Okay, we need 3 more pointers to solve this question. If you see point number 1, point number 2, point number 3, so we are given 3 pointers, we shall be able to solve. So when you structure information correctly, you know whether the feasibility or means what is the feasibility of solving the question as well. Everyone, the point is clear, everyone? What I'm trying to convey here is when we are thinking of structuring. Okay. Okay, great. Okay, that's great. Okay. Now let's go to the next question. Okay. In this question, okay, we are given, so here, in the structuring information, okay, the structure is given. Okay, now how we are supposed to do the interpretation, okay, and solve this question. Okay, that is what we are supposed to focus on. Okay, so I'll give you around 7 to 8 minutes to understand this question. Okay, and then we'll discuss this question. Okay, try karo, ek baar solve ho jaye to great hai. Okay, here we'll focus on the small reasoning pointers as well, which you can think when you're solving. Okay, so read the question, how many means, and try to understand each and every part. Okay, so you have around 7 minutes to do that. I've shared the sheet in your chat. Okay, so you can means click and you can open the doc itself. Okay, if this is not visible properly. Okay, everyone, let's start. 7 minutes up. Okay, we can start. Okay, so we have Q1 to Q10. Everyone, is it visible, everyone? Just a minute, I'll share the PowerPoint. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll start with the first part, which is to discuss the pointers again. So when you read information, you have to note the pointers, okay, and write in your own form, means write in your own language equation, okay, or equation, or put in table. There are three things you can do. Okay, so number one, number two. If you are not able to do two, at least have do one, or point number one. If you do that, you have information in one place. Okay, if there are 7-8 pointers given, if you have written everything in your form and if you put everything in the structure, then you're done. Your means you will be able to solve the question 90% of the times. Okay, so that is what the means we are supposed to do. Now here in this question, okay, we are given that a person gets 400 for right prediction and loses 100 for wrong prediction. So what I can say is right plus 400, wrong is minus 100. Sounds like any kind of a competitive exam, CAT or something, you know, where you have options. Okay, so CAT mein marking is plus 3 minus 1. Similarly here have plus 4 minus 100. Okay, so okay, so you can think of it. Okay, following table gives the prediction of each of the 5 person as to whom winner would be. For example, in Q1, K predicted Bob to win. K is predicting Bob to win. L and N predicted Clive to win. L and N Clive to win. J and M predicted Elgar to win. So these are the five people, J, K, L, M, N. They are making the guesses. So and they have predicted, these are their predictions. Okay. So samajh mein aa raha hai, you can see the other part as well. Everything is quite easy to understand. Okay. Next, at the end of the 10 games, it turned out that if any person had predicted a single would win each of the 10 games, he would not have gained or lost any amount. Anyone who means made sense of this particular statement, this particular statement which I have written here. Anyone? Great man, very, very excellent. Okay. So that means if I, let's say, K predicted that Adam will win all the matches. Okay. K predicted that Adam will win the matches, then K would have got zero. Okay. Means he would not have earned or lost any amount. That means he would have made some correct guesses. For each correct guesses, he would have made 400. For each wrong guess, that is 10 minus C. Because overall he has made 10 predictions. He would have lost 100. Okay. If C is 0, then he would have lost 1000 rupees. Okay. If C is 1, this amount is 400 minus 900, which is minus 500. If C is 2, this amount is 2 into 400, 800, plus 10 minus 2 is 8, 8 minus 100, 0. That means correct predictions are, so correct predictions 2. So if you are guessing anyone, Adam will win all the matches, that means Adam and you are predicting that you will get 0, that means Adam has won exactly 2 matches. Now you can do it for any single player. Okay, means instead of K you can take J, you can take anyone. And instead of the single player, you could have taken any player. That means each one has won 2 matches. Everyone, is it clear? I'll wait for your response, okay, in case you're not able to get it. Anyone? Saloni? Okay. Okay, so I'll give you another example, you know? Okay, so I'll just give you another example to solve this one. So let me change this. Okay. So no, doesn't mean that. Okay, not necessarily Mohit. Okay, so I'll just means I'll underline it again. Okay, and then I'll explain again. Okay, so let's say okay, you are writing an exam. Okay, and there you are getting, let's say, plus 3 minus 1. Okay. And you marked all the answers. Okay, there are five questions. You marked all. Everyone? So what is the maximum score can you get? In case you have five correct, you will plus 15. If you have four correct, one is definitely wrong. That means you'll get 11. Clear? If you have three correct, two are definitely wrong, you'll get 7. If you have made two correct, then four, three are definitely wrong because you are marking all the ones, isn't it? So your score will be 3. If you have made one correct, your answer is one of the answers correct and four are wrong, you'll score minus 1. If all the five are wrong, you'll get minus 5. So that is what is happening here as well. Okay. Now the scene is any person. Who are the people who are making guesses or predictions? JKLMN. These are the people from the audience. Any of the persons. Let's say you can take KJAM. So you're taking one of the persons, and you're taking one of the players. Okay. So if I take, let's say, Clive. So I'm predicting that Clive will win all the matches. I would not gained or lost any amount. So for this thing, these are the scenarios. Okay, in this case, what are the scenarios? You have 10 rounds, okay, 10 quizzes. If I make one correct prediction, I'll have 9 wrong prediction. That means how much will I earn? 400 minus 900, which is minus 500. If I make two correct predictions, 8 predictions will be wrong. That means how much I'll earn? Zero. That is the case this question is talking about, this particular line is talking about. That means if you pick any single player, you have two right predictions. That means each one is winning at exactly twice. Okay. Is it clear, Pratik? Sorry, Saloni and Mohit? Clear now? Okay. So that is okay. So this is what I call pointer. Okay. So this is a pointer, very important pointer. Every player, two wins. Now, when you have a structure given, okay, in this case, structure is given. Second important part is structuring information is where you're putting this information. If you're putting here in some side notes, that won't suffice. You should write somewhere where you can see it, okay, where you can use it, where it's visible. Okay, means it should be in front of your eyes. Okay, the problem in solving any logical reasoning question or DI question is when information is there, but that's not into your head. Okay, so you have to put it in consciously. Okay. Next one. At the end of the series, J received maximum of 2000. Now I guess everyone is clear. How can we find? Okay, means how many correct prediction by J and wrong prediction by J? Everyone, can you find it? Very good. Okay, that's now very much clear. Okay, so for J, I'm writing here 6 correct prediction, 4 wrong. Okay, K neither gained or lost any amount. So for K, we can say 2 correct predictions, 8 wrong prediction. L had made, okay. Now, again, this is very typical of CAT. What I mean by typical of CAT is they give unnecessary long sentences which could have been made very simple. Na? Means this, how much, 20, 25 letter word long statement could have been written in 10 words only. Okay, let's see. Had L made one more correct prediction and J made one more wrong prediction, the amount gained by them at the end of the quiz would have interchanged. Now if you see, J made one more wrong prediction. J has 6 correct prediction, 4 wrong. That means we want J to have one lesser prediction, that is 5 correct and 5 wrong. If J do that, J becomes same as L. Everyone clear? So wo L ke baare mein whatever information is given, that is not even required. Interchange and everything is not required. J if make one prediction less, it will become same as L. So that is something which could have been given. Then that could have been solved very easily. So I'm writing for L 5 correct, 5 wrong. Everyone clear? Is this line? So this is the second pointer we have written again. Next, the total number of matches between L and N both predicted same player to win. 50% of the match won by the same player, as in this one and this one. L and N, they are nowhere else. That means Q1 Clive and Q10 David. One correct prediction and one is wrong prediction. That is what we can write. Okay, so everything what we have written is that is what means that the pointers are made. Now pointers has to be put into the structure to solve. Okay, so here all the structure is there. Okay, but we are not able to means we won't be able to solve if we don't know what else we are supposed to do. Okay, so next we'll move forward. Okay, this is something which we already done. Okay, 2 correct, 2 losses, J's predictions, K, and then L and N predicted together. Okay, now the big one. Okay, everyone, how to proceed? Okay, how are you supposed to solve this one? Okay, because if you see, apart from Q1 and Q10, we don't know anything else. So where should we start? We have this information, which is in terms of wins. Okay, but if you see, we have 10 into 5, 50 points pointers. Out of 50 pointers, out only 2 pointers we know where a win could be. Okay, and then we don't have much information. So always start with something which is which has a lot of information. Okay, so maybe we can start with J or K. Why J or K? Because J we have maximum number of correct predictions, for K we have minimum number of correct predictions. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll start with J. Now look at J's pattern. J is here, J is here, J is here, 1, 2, 3, then J is here, 4, then J is here, 3, 4, 5, 6. So what do you see? J is kind of biased towards Elgar, right? So J has predicted Elgar to win how many matches? 6. Everyone? Everyone, is it clear? J has predicted Elgar to win 6. How many Elgar can actually win? How many Elgar can actually win? That means out of these 6, 2 are correct, 4 are wrong. Is it clear, everyone? Because if that is not happening, J overall has 4 wrong predictions. If any one of these predictions, okay, any of these predictions, Q4, Q6, Q8, Q9, that is wrong. 4 minimum are wrong when he is making prediction for Elgar. That means those are definitely wrong. So out of these 6, 4 are definitely wrong. Okay, so minimum 4 are wrong. And altogether, Jay has made only 4 wrong predictions. Yes or no, everyone? Is it clear what I'm trying to convey here? So what I'm trying to convey here, Jay Elgar can win 2 only. Jay has 2 correct predictions out of 6 in Elgar's zoo. That means out of 6, 4 are definitely wrong. And overall, Jay has made 6 correct predictions, 4 wrong predictions. All the 4 wrong predictions are with Elgar. Anyone, any confusion, doubt? Okay. Now, next thing, everyone. Okay, which since you guys are means in the beginning of means learning how to solve logical reasoning questions. Okay. So there are 2 types of information. One is positive information, other one is negative information. So positive information, we know that all other correct predictions by J were correct. So I'm writing this is green, this is marked green, this is marked green. You could use tick or cross, whatever you want to prepare. Okay. Now for Q4, what we can say is Bob, Clive, David, and Elgar, they have lost. That is very, very important. I'll tell you later on why. Q6 also, we can say Adam, Bob, Clive, Adam, Bob, David, Elgar, they have lost. Similarly for Q8 and Q9. Is there anything else we can mark negative information? Anyone? Everyone, my point is clear. Q4, Q6, Q8, Q9. Wherever we have greens, that are tick. Wherever we don't have greens, okay, the other members of the column should be marked red. Okay. Anything else can we do here? Apart from these reds. That is why this is important. Everyone, that we write information explicitly. Yes, Q1, it's okay. That means these are also red. These are also not possible. Tick, we can write cross. Very good, Yogesh. Very good. Now this one we already noted that out of this one, I mean, if this is not one, then this one is one. Okay, that means this is also not possible. So understanding, everyone, what is importance of negative information also. Since we have negative information of Clive, we could get David's positive information and then we cross mark everything else. Okay. So if you see, I have just marked Ellen here, and Q10 we have marked David has won Q10, and we have marked negative for David's other sections. Okay. Now, so we have used J. Okay, J is we have not seen for Elgar what he has done. Okay, for Elgar we are still thinking about it. Okay, means we are not sure. For others we are sure. Okay. Now let's start with K. K has made 2 correct predictions, 8 wrong predictions. K here, K here. All these 2 are correct. That means all other are wrong predictions. So I'm marking all these other predictions by K as cross cross. Everyone? Okay. Yes, exactly. Very good, Mayank. Okay. Next thing is when you do that, okay. You can see again. Okay, so we have marked it. Okay, we have marked everything. Okay, now when you do that, okay, you get wait a second. That is done. That is K. Everything we have marked cross, cross, cross. This is cross, this is cross, this is cross, this is cross. Okay, yeah. Now if you see for Bob, these are the only 2 places left. So he has to win these 2. Okay. Now, so I marked Bob's, these 2 are the only places left. So these has to be correct one. Now we are left with Q1, Q3, Q7. one win is required for Adam and two wins are required for Elgar. J, we need two correct predictions for Elgar. Okay. And we need three wrong predictions are already there. Okay. So one wrong prediction we have to get. Same thing for L also. L, we need 1, 2, 3, 4. So we need one correct prediction, then one wrong prediction. Now, okay. Okay. So one wrong. Okay. Sorry. One, two wrong predictions. Now, everyone, okay, so if you see, okay, out of these three, okay, two are won by J, correct? Out of these Q1 and Q4, Q1 and Q3, okay, sorry, Q1 and Q4, one is correct by L. Now, exactly one is correct by L, because L, if you see, 1, 2, 3, 4 are already done. So, for L, we need extra win. So, out of Q1 and Q3, there can be only one win. That means Q1 has to be by, that has to be correct. I'll just go to the previous step again. Okay. If you see for L, there are five correct predictions, five wrong predictions. This is correct prediction by L. This is also correct. This is also correct. This is also. For L, these are the two places left. One and out of these two, one is correct, one is wrong. In Elgar's row, we see out of three, two are correct predictions because he has to win twice. Out of these one and two, only one can be correct. That means this has to be definitely correct. Okay, now once you are done with it, okay, we are left with these two places. If I put this Q3 correct, then we'll have Q7 wrong, sorry, Q7 correct. So here means if this is tick, this is cross, this is tick, this is cross. If I mark this as cross, this will be tick, this will be cross, and this will be tick. Both the solutions are feasible because L has to win one more, J has to win one more, and in both the cases Adam and Elgar are winning one matches each. So this is what we have. This is the final structure we have. Now we can solve the questions. Okay, so if you see, the point here is, okay, that once you made the information, you have to understand what is positive information, what is negative information. So when you are solving, make the note down the information, okay, and note down. So this part was very, very important. First part was, this was important, level one. Okay, now this is comprehension, everyone. Okay, this is logic, the reasoning part. Okay, and next part is how you are putting that information inside it, that is structuring, including the making of structure. So I hope everyone understood how you are supposed to understand, use the information to get solve such questions. Okay. Now I'll close the session, everyone. Please solve Kakuro and means the greatest book of puzzles and teaser. That will give you a very good start in terms of reasoning and logic building. Okay, so I'll take the leave now, everyone. Good night.